Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's got some space here. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. Well, look at the clock here. You're inside of a minute. First half hasn't gone that well for you. How are you going to play this drive?
Well, I've been told by my coaches previously that the intelligent approach, go ahead and run out the clock and start over. Don't make any more mistakes. But there's also something to understanding that you get this last drive here. You get the ball to start the second half. Try and go 2-for-1 here. Get some points now and come out of the locker room and get more points again and get your momentum really built up.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Brady. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. Now the Bucks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
1st and 10 here. You know, if they could just get 3 out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a 2-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle.
That throw by Brady, incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Brady's incompletion on 1st down leads to a 2nd and 10. Throwing the out route, incomplete. It's Jones. The Bucks going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. 2nd down pass play got them 8 yards. Now they've got a 3rd and a couple remaining. He's going deep for Brown. And Brady going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the 1st half. Really nice pick there for the reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week. And a good story on that, he said he didn't even know he won the award. His buddy had to call him. He saw on television and said, hey, congratulations. How about that?
And I'll bet you his buddy said, well, since you didn't know, I'll just go ahead and claim the award, right? And everything that goes along with it. But the reason he won the award the previous week and what we just saw there, instincts, understanding where the play is going and being able to make a play on the football.
Turns out to be a great idea to tuck that one. Good for 24 yards.
1st and 10 at the 35-yard line.
On 1st down, Wilson. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the 2nd quarter. And Myers able to knock it through. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we send you cross country to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. 2nd half action back underway. Fielded in the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Coming
coming to the line here to begin their next drive. The Seahawks offense. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. 12 yards there and a first down.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. From the 36, Wilson. They'll roll him out right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds the defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback, I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
He'll find Metcalf, and he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Tyler Lockett was the target there, and that'll bring up second down. Play action. Now Wilson. And this is incomplete. Gerald Everett is tight end, the intended receiver. And it's third down. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker, and his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Pretty much everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. A big seam, and he might go all the way. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, 81 yards. And the Bucs are able to cut into that deficit.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
Extra point try now for Succop. And the lead will be cut down to 14.
Makes the score Seahawks 31, Buccaneers 17. Bradley Pinion.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Second and six at the 19-yard line.
A four receiver set here. Three to the left, one to the right, second and six. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, They almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
The throw right sideline here is complete. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead. On first down, it's Austin. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Seahawks, first down. First and 10 at the
from the gun, Wilson. And he's got his man in stride, complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. On the carry here, it's Austin. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield.
Back at the 34-yard line.
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And the box with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Operating from the gun, Wilson. And he's got his man on the out route. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. From the gun, Wilson. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Russell Wilson now with 4 touchdown passes on the afternoon. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. He's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Buccaneers, 17.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They're down 3 touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it first and 10. Now this pass brought in by Brown. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. But it's going to be second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
He's going deep for Brown. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. Marquise Blair, second round pick from Utah, there to bat it away.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Not often do fourth down conversions result in 23 yards, but that's the case here. First down. And a catch right side by Evans. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. That one goes for 30 yards. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bucs are able to close the gap just a bit.
He has been an integral part of the offense all season, and now in the playoffs, he's carrying it over. Had the touchdown last week in the wild card game. Now his second TD of the playoffs.
Showing some consistency, and that's something that we have to keep in mind about the playoffs, because we often think you have to be spectacular in order to win. I think consistent is what you're looking for. That can get you to the finish line.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And now first downs are key. They want to keep that clock moving, up by two scores as they try to cement their place in the conference championship round in 1 week's time.
And I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning. Trying to ice a game. There's plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try to finish off the game.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
A big hole there. How about him handling the point of attack? Just positioning himself so that run could go right off of his backside and deep into the secondary.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
No gain on the play. Second and 10. At the 43-yard.
Looking to throw on second down. Wilson got a man, and he hits him in stride.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On third down, Austin. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That'll pick up the first down for Seattle on a gain of 18.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball. You often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offense.
And he is in for the Seattle touchdown.
That I came up. I know my granny gonna pray. We had to get it from A to B.